Hi, and thank you for using the Zen Protocol Alpha. We'll be going over a tutorial today with the Mac OS X installation. So first, we're going to assume that you've already downloaded and installed the Mono for Mac, and that you've downloaded the Zen Alpha. We're going to go ahead and double click, and we'll see this easy drag and drop into the applications folder. And we'll close that and right click the open button. And we'll just click open here after the pop-up comes up. Remember to right click on your first time opening. So we'll notice that each wallet acts as its own node. So we'll be downloading all the blocks and accepting them. You have four sections of the wallet. The first is your actual wallet, where you'll be able to copy your address and send other people Zen or tokens. And your contract section, where you'll be able to activate contracts. Your portfolio, where you'll be able to see other tokens, all your tokens, and your previous transactions. So if you scroll down on the main, on the alpha page, you'll be able to note see all these instructions here. And at the top, we'll notice that there's a link to alpha.zenprotocol.com. There are four main sections of the alpha website currently. The first is your explorer, where you'll be able to see all the active and inactive options or contracts that are available. You'll be able to go to your templates, where you'll be able to create a call option that we've already coded for you. You'll have your faucet, which we'll use in a minute in order to receive our first Zen, and our oracles, which we will explain more about later. So for now, we're going to go to our wallet and copy our address and paste it here into the faucet. And we can notice that our transaction was committed successfully. And we'll go back to our wallet, where we'll notice that all the blocks have been synced and work on the current block, number 49. And we'll go to our transactions and notice that we have received 50 million kalapas, the equivalent of half a zen. We'll now go and create our call option. So we're going to click on the templates folder, already open up over here. And we're going to create a call option. And now we're going to go back to our oracles, this over here, which is open right here. Our oracles are ways of bringing in our real-world information into our platform. We're currently using intrinio.com. We'll be able to see the different commits. And let's go with an Apple stock call option. So we'll notice it's trading at 173. So we're going to call it our Apple call option. We'll notice that it's already hard-coded to Zen for the prices. Our Oracle is already committed to the Oracle that we are using. We're going to use our Apple. And we're going to notice that the price is 173. So we'll set our strike at 165 and our premium at 5, meaning that there will be a 3 Zen profit. And we're going to create our call option. Now, when you create the call option, you'll receive a pre-coded contract. We'll be able to copy it, go to our contract section, paste, and we're going to put it on the chain for 50 blocks. This will make sure that we have ample time to use it. We're going to go ahead and activate it. We see the contract activated. And we'll notice in our transaction, we sent the Zen in order to activate the contract. And now we can go to the Explorer. And we'll notice our Apple call option is active until block 100. We are currently on 49. So that's exactly 50 from the next block. And we're going to add some collateral. The collateral will allow other people or ourselves to buy the call option. So in order to add collateral, we're going to go back to our wallet and we're going to copy this address and send some collateral. We'll paste it in the destination, copy the data, paste it here. And because the premium was 5 and we want to create 10,000 options, we're gonna send 50,000 Zen. And we'll notice now, if we go back to the Explorer, that our call option now has 50,000 collateral. And we can also see that it was sent. And now we're going to go ahead and buy some of those call options. So we're going to click on the buy button. And that we need to add our address so it knows where to send the call options. And now again, we're going to send Zen in order to buy the options. So we're going to copy the address, copy the data, paste it here. And we're going to send 20,000 Zen at 5 as the premium. This will give us 4,000 options. So again, we'll go to our transactions. Notice the 20,000 was sent. And we'll be able to see that we have received 4,000 call options, and it's also able to see it in our portfolio. And again, we'll go to our Explorer and we'll go to our call option. And we're gonna now exercise those call options. So again, we're gonna put in our address so they know where to send the earnings from the call option. And again, we're gonna copy and paste this address. So we're going to send. And notice this time we're going to be sending call options, not Zen. And we'll send 2,000 call options. Now the strike was 165 with a 5 premium, meaning 170. And it's trading at 173, but we already paid 5 for the premium. So we should be making 8 profit times 2,000 options should be 16,000 Zen. We can see we've received it here. And our portfolio, you can see now we only have 2,000 options left. Okay, I hope you guys enjoyed this tutorial. And if you have any questions, feel free to send an email to info@zenprotocol.com or directly to Isaac@zenprotocol.com. And we look forward to the next video. Have a great day.